We have already seen how we were able to save that data without AJAX. We were directly able to take that data to the server and stored it there. Now we shall study how to do the same thing using AJAX. You must have noticed one very interesting thing, that we hardly write any code in MVC. Very little code is being required. Very little rather. And the same thing will go on when we do it AJAX based. We'll see how little code will be required in converting this to AJAX. We'll start. Let us see what do we have at present. Let us run it. We can store some record, because I wanted to do something which we missed in our last lecture. So when you pick some photo or something, developers me, when you save it, the record gets saved, but this is not getting empty. So let us first do that, make it empty, and then we'll go for AJAX. You just need one line to do that, coming to our home controller. Here, when the record is saved, here we can write model state dot clear. Doing this particular line will actually remove all those fields and reset them to their default values. Let us run it and see what is the output. So we can type u@u.com, date of birth, select BCA, and browse to some file, and let us click save. So the moment we have clicked save, these are all reset back to their original value. This is something that was missing in our previous one. So the line is model state dot clear. You don't have to write bulky code like we do it in ASP.NET, set text empty, do that. Here you just have to put model state dot clear, and it will just reset the whole form back to the default values. Let us now go for the AJAXing of it. We have to put AJAX into this here only. So I'll do one thing, I'll comment it off. Wait a minute, instead of okay, I'll start writing over here, and then we can do changes here. I'll write the comment rather. So this comments of this line here, I can write now @ using AJAX dot begin form, and now I can start writing the options here. One is AJAX options, but I'll need to still add this ink type here, so I'll have to choose the correct overload. The correct overload will be this one, action name, controller name, AJAX options. So action is index, controller is home, and AJAX options, I'll write new AJAX options, and I can set all those properties into this one. Hope that this one is okay. And now I can write the properties. First of all, HTTP method is equal to post. This is one we'll need here. Then we can use on begin also. So we'll have to tell the JavaScript function, and we can find a suitable place here to include that JavaScript. I am just writing it too quickly here. Script type is equal to text by JavaScript, and here I am writing function before sending, and this is one quick before sending. So this is one JavaScript function that I have added that will be called before the AJAX call is sent to the server. So coming back here, on begin is equal to, I can write the name of the JavaScript function. We'll tell the purpose of it just now. Then confirm is that are you sure and all. If you want, you can add it also. Okay, anyhow. Then we have update target ID. Update target ID will be the ID of a control in which we'll display the message. So I'm leaving it this, this one should not be required now because we'll not be using it. Here we can write span ID is equal to SP message, and I will copy this one. So whatever response, I'll just align it correctly. Home, new AJAX option. So here I'm writing now, update target ID is equal to the ID of that span. So whatever response comes from the server, that will be displayed here. And I can put, of course, put the CSS colors and all. So having done this, now this is all this we have set. On begin, update target ID, and I've commented out the other portions so that it remains there, and this is an alert that will be called before that AJAX call is sent. So only very minor changes: AJAX.begin form, name of the action, name of the controller, AJAX options, HTTP method, post, on begin, update target ID. If you want to be even more specific, you can write on success to tell saved and all, whatever you want to do. That is up to you. Now we'll come to our controller and see what changes we need here. So we are in the controller. I'll do one thing. I'll retain this one and comment it off and add the same name function again so that it that will be used for AJAX. I'm writing it AJAX. So here during AJAX file will not be available to us. We have to use some alternate method of uploading this file asynchronously, because MVC will not allow this file to come asynchronously here. So we can remove it, and if you allow it to be there, you can test it also. It will always be null. Even if you upload some file, it will always be null. So I'm removing it this way also. This bracket also goes, and the last one, there is this matching bracket, this goes. Formatting it, this line should also be removed. Then this is it. If model state dot is valid, then I'll store it to view bag. Model state dot clear. Here I can write is, instead of using view bag, we shall be writing here return JSON, and inside JSON I'll write saved. So and comma JSON request behavior dot allow get this one. So when the record is saved, model state will be cleared and a saved message will be displayed on that span. Else we are not going to do anything. And otherwise, if errors occur, then I can write here some error occurred. Hardly your code will reach here because your client side calculations will always work. And if you want to be even more secure, then you can probably implement try catch here And instead of sending saved, you can send that try catch error message there. That freedom is all with you there. So what I'm finding is that this code is even more simpler. I have deleted lines rather than added here. So I've never used this one. I can remove this one also, it's redundant, and this one. So this is the simple code that works. Let us try to store it some data and call it now. Let us add some records here. We'll add axy@a.com. Date of birth I'll choose, qualification I can pick, and photo won't work right now. We'll come to it later. Save before sending that alert. Then OK, saved. So the record has been saved. One thing you must have noticed is that this hasn't evaporated this time. This has not been cleared. So I'll come to both the problems. One is with the photo and clearing this one. But before that, let us see whether we have that axy@a.com in our database or not. Show table data. TBL registration, show table data. We are looking for axy. Yes, wow, it is there. Now I'll quickly come to both the issues. First is the issue of your file upload. File upload has to be done in an asynchronous manner. That has to be asynchronous. So this means you have to resort to jQuery or other third-party libraries that allow you to upload that file to the server. So why I made this alert? This alert I specifically made so that this is the point where you can, before sending this data to the server, you should first send that file to the server. You will be sending that file to the server first, and here you can write the code for asynchronous sending. This is the point where you can write the code for sending the file asynchronous. You can test whether some file has been really uploaded, selected. If it has not been selected, then you can simply prohibit by returning false here. No call will go ahead. Just return false and nothing will proceed. And if a file has been chosen, then you can use the jQuery steps to take that file to the server first. And once you receive an OK from the server, that jQuery you'll have to jQuery file upload, you will have to work on your own. You can find a number of helpful sites for this. So there are various plugins also available. You can make use of them and do that hit testing. Okay, then the second problem is, the second problem that relates is that emptying of that one. So how to do that? For this we can use this comma to include on success is equal to and write some JavaScript code here, a JavaScript function here, and inside that function you will have to manually empty those controls and boxes and reset them to that value. So you will have to use plain JavaScript for that and plain jQuery for that. So that is something that you have to add. So the cost of adding AJAX is that it becomes heavy on JavaScript, but the C# code becomes smaller. So this is how you can tweak into this. Mostly you will have to rely heavily on the AJAX client side JavaScript, and there are libraries that can help you in this. So this is all about our AJAX support. If I were to revise it, you can add a function for before sending, after sending, and perform some initialization. Maybe also do take that opportunity to upload file to the server, and once the request completes, you can use that JavaScript function to reset the controls. This is the thing that we did on the server side. TBL registration, this is of no use, we can remove it, this doesn't work in this case, and this is the one that we used for the earlier one. And I'm dead sure that you don't even require these also, these two lines, but anyhow they're used because you are doing model state validation on the client side mostly, so you don't need to check this model state is valid. So you could have simply even removed these lines off, but I've retained them so that you can check and see. However, I still believe this is not required and this one is not required. So okay, thanks. Now so this completes our whole steps of how to create a data entry form and store its data to the server using AJAX, not using AJAX, and also including a file upload control and including validations in a very standard manner. We used annotations in a very standard manner. So this is how you can always do. We tried to incorporate all the scenarios possible. So thanks now.